Because see, we try to impress man and not understand that our Heavenly Father is looking at us saying, what is wrong with you? Why are you believing these lies? Why are you allowing these lies? When you go to Tony about the 2 Corinthians 5 and 10, the Bible says we got to cast down these wicked imaginations. Why are you entertaining these thoughts? Why are you entertaining these lies? What I've been going through for the last 2 years, well, you know what? That's telling me something wrong. Because for some, 2 years you going through and you ain't got no breakthrough. You have not grown. You have not pushed forth. Something is wrong, because when the woman of God read this morning, when God takes us through pain, He blesses us with a breakthrough. Come on here. It's gonna give birth to a purpose. Everything that you go through, even when I'm going through trials and tribulations, I don't just come out hurt. I come out with victory. I come out more anointed. If you're going through trials and tribulations and you're not being anointed, something is wrong with your going through. Something is wrong. Because you got to understand, we got to know how to endure heartache as a good soldier. Why are we angry? We're angry. Why are we angry? Get those angers, get those cares to the Lord. He paid the price that you don't have to be angry. 9 times out of 10, you mad at folks and they gone on by their life and you still angry. You still mad. Some of these people are dead. Some of these people gone on enjoying their life, having a good time, and you passing by. Thinking about mad at what they doing. You ain't hurt no people. You hurt yourself. And so we got to understand, we are living our life by lies. And God did not die for us to be lied to. Because when you live your life based on the lie, you are a child of the devil. That's why you got to say, no, no more lies. No, I want to be free. I'm confronting my issues. When you confront your issues, guess what? It's not going to look good. It's not going to feel good. Because you're going to say, that ain't me. But you got to say, yo, yes, it is me. I've been doing this. I've been acting like this. Because that's the only way God is going to come in. God is going to come in when you have to say, Lord, it's me. Read Psalms 51. It was me, God, that have sinned against you. Come on here. I sinned against you. I did wrong in your sight. I need you to create in me a clean heart. Renew in me a right spirit. Because my spirit is not right. Don't take your Holy Ghost away from me. Every time you hear the word of God, that's an opportunity for you to get right. We don't just know that we're gonna wake up tomorrow. We don't. And we don't want to live our life taking it for granted, just assuming we're gonna wake up. Because while we still wasting time on ourselves, we're supposed to be helping somebody.
Right, right, right.
We still talking about what we're going through, and you're supposed to be on half full say. You're supposed to be walking in your ministry.
Right.
But we sitting up here worrying about our own self. See, that's selfishness. That's pride. God didn't die for you to be worried about you. He said, Matthew 6:33, when you see first the kingdom of God, all these things will be added. They can't be added if you stuck with you. We got to understand, we got to go through the process. Going through the hard knocks of life. God is allowing us to go through these trials and tribulations because He's trying to teach us to pray more. He's trying to teach us how to lean and depend on Him. So when the enemy is bombarding your mind, hear me. When he bombarding your mind with these thoughts, you got to withstand him and say, I ain't backing down. I'm standing on the word of God. No more would I bleed your life. No more would I let you send these thoughts to my mind. But I send it back in the name of Jesus. I will not be your trash can. I will not allow you to put these legalities and accusations on my life. Lord, and every thought that's set up against me, I condemn it in the name of Jesus. I cast you down. You gotta cast down these thoughts that are bombarding your mind. See, you gotta understand, the enemy send those thoughts because you know he knows there's a breakthrough on the other side.
My God.
And see, we got some people folding up under the pressure. Well, they talking about me. They don't like me. They ain't treat me right. They didn't hug me like they hugged them. Man, that's kindergarten. How long you going to keep talking about that mess? You got folks losing their life and you still talking about they ain't talking to me. They ain't hugging me. Grow up. This is not kindergarten. This is not preschool. This is for the soldiers. Come on here. Come on. You can't take no kind of hit. You can't grow up. How long must you be in elementary school?
Yeah.
Come on here. You keep on eating pamplin. That's what the old folk call it, pamplin. Put some cereal in your milk. You ought to be eating fried chicken or eating some pork chop, but you still, they looking at me funny. They ain't treat me right. They ain't call my name. Man, come on here. You got folk dying out here. People need Jesus. You walking by, people need Jesus, but you too busy with your issue. Well, I'm going to. I want them to know. Man, come on. You keep talking about you. We talking about Jesus. The Bible talk about evil about with Stephen. Stephen was stoned to death. Come on here. Because of preaching the good news. You got believers who stand before Jesus. Well, I couldn't do nothing because they rolled their eyes at me and they didn't treat me right. They overlooked me. They didn't allow me to walk in my... Man, come on. Come on. Come on. You think Jesus allowed you to bring you on this earth for you not to do nothing? That's an open shame. That's a shame that he did everything he did. If God don't do nothing else for us, he don't draw some stuff, some victories he have delivered us from, and our life don't show it. Our life don't show it. Because if we was grateful, see, that what showed me about believers versus the Jews, they remember. Remember I told y'all when I went to that Passover, they took 2 hours reading over the scriptures. They remember. See, we forget. You forgot that he don't brought you out. We forgot that he don't tuck up your debts. We forgot he don't heal your body. He don't save your marriage. He don't heal your child. We forgot all of that. And now, this what I'm mad at. No, see, the devil want us fixated on what we're going through. See, if he got you distracted, he got you. See, because if I'm distracted on they talking about me, I can't hit on what God called me to do. And see, you got to understand that what the enemy trying to do. He'll try to have us distracted with that little petty stuff. See, you got to know this is the season God is raising up some warriors. Come on here, that you're going to have some tough skin. No, I ain't got time for that. You want to say, oh, I don't want to hear that. You know, when people want to call you with stuff and talk about this and talk about that, I ain't got time for that. No, it's time to go forward. And if you don't want to do the things of God, bye.